Well, it's that time of the year. It's time for apples. So I'd like to show you how I like to make apple butter. I like my apple butter to be nice and dark and thick. And this is a result of having those apples cook down and caramelize and turn into something beautiful. So here are the ingredients if you would like to do a screenshot, or they'll also be below the video if you would like to print them out. I'm going to use a crock pot to make this, so it'll be super easy. So we'll first get started by mixing up our sugar, and this is an organic sugar, so that's why it looks a little bit off-white. You can certainly just use a regular white granulated sugar for this. And I'm adding some spices. I'm adding cinnamon and cloves. You can add nutmeg or maybe a pumpkin spice blend. That would be nice, so be creative. We'll add our vanilla later in the process, okay? So go ahead and cut your apples directly into your sugar mixture. This is probably going to be the most time-consuming part of making apple butter, is slicing all of the apples, because you have to peel them and then core them. Also right here, I'm adding my dark brown sugar. I almost forgot to add that earlier. So I think that you can get a little apple coring machine at Bed Bath & Beyond. I do believe they are about 20 bucks there, if that's something you'd like to do, but I do mine manually. So this is an old crock pot, and the reason why I'm saying that is because I can adjust the heat on this crock pot. And so you will need to adjust your heat accordingly with your crock pot. I'm going to just say low and high. My low is about 200 degrees Fahrenheit, and my high, I'm going to say, is around 375 to 400, okay? So we're just going to put all of our apples in here, and I ended up with about 3.5 quarts of diced apples. I'm going to cover it, and I'm putting it on low heat, and I'm cooking it overnight. So I cooked it about probably about 10 hours. And so the next morning they were nice and soft. And at this time we can go ahead and puree them down to that's nice and smooth. Unless you want it a little chunky, you can certainly leave it a little bit chunky. You'll just want to leave about probably 10% of the apples where you can visibly see them. But I like mine smooth, so I went ahead and pureed it down good. And then at this point, we'll leave it uncovered. I turned the heat up to high, and I stirred it throughout the day. And it makes the house smell wonderful. But so about, I don't know, about 8 hours later, it was looking a lot like this, but it wasn't quite ready yet. And now about almost 10 to 12 hours later, it was ready. You can see how much it's reduced from the side of the crock pot. It's reduced almost by half. And so at this point, we'll go ahead and add our vanilla, and I'll cook it about another 15 minutes with the vanilla in there, and then it's ready. So we can go ahead and jar it up. I got 3 pints from my 3.5 quarts of apples. And I like to put it in the refrigerator. It will thicken up a little bit once you put it in there. And then before I serve it, I like to warm it up a little bit. It kind of brings out more of that flavor. And we like to have it maybe on a Saturday morning. I like to make a loaf of brioche bread, and we'll use the whole entire pint on one loaf of bread. My family digs into this in no time. We also use it as a spread on things like English muffins or a topping for ice cream sundaes. So it's just really, really good this time of year, and it makes the house smell wonderful, like I said. So if you enjoyed the video, please let me know by giving me a big thumbs up. And also, you are welcome to share the video too on your favorite social media by clicking that little arrow right down there that's close to the like button. So I hope you're able to give it a try, and thanks so much for watching. Y'all have a beautiful day.